गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग ए प्रॉब्लम बेस्ड ऑन द एनालिसिस ऑफ बार हैविंग सेम क्रॉस सेक्शन एरिया। दैट मींस द प्रॉब्लम इफ ग्राफ बार हैविंग क्रॉस सेक्शन एरिया ऑफ 1000 मिलीमीटर स्क्वायर इज सब्जेक्टेड टू ए एक्सियल फोर्स एज शोन इन फिगर। फाइंड द टोटल इनर्शियल डिफॉर्मेशन ऑफ द बार गिवन दैट मॉडुलस ऑफ इलास्टिसिटी इज 1.05 into 10 raised to 5 meter per mm square. So that means here is a brass bar having three cross, having three section A, B, B, C and C, D, which have same cross sectional area. That will be 1000 millimeter square. So we have to solve that problem on the basis of the law of equilibrium. So that means summation of all the forces which are acting in the left hand side equal to summation of all the forces equal to acting in the right hand side. So that means we have to break into the three sections AB, BC and CD. So first we have to consider first section, that is AB. Here we have to see that 50 kN is acting on section AB is tensile. So first we have to apply the 50 kN is applied in tensile. The form of tensile, that is a 50 kN, same as the part of in opposite direction acting is a 50 kN for the equilibrium. Now we have to consider the second part, that is BC. Here we have to see the on section C applying 20 kN is acting compressive. So that means in the same for the equilibrium we have to add the same force in the opposite direction, that is also a 20 kN. Now we are considering the third section, that is the CD. In CD section, we have seen the 10 kN is acting a compressive load on the portion of D. So we have to apply 10 kN load on the section of D. So we have, for managing the equilibrium, we have to apply the 10 kN compressive load on the portion of C. So now what we are going to the for equilibrium condition, we have to see that the 80 kN is applying the summation of left hand side. 50 kN plus 20 kN plus 10 kN, that summation will be 80. Same for going for the right hand side, you have to see 50 plus 20 plus 10. So that means 80 will be equal to 80. So that means the breaking of the these forces equal to 0. So that means the section beyond distributing the forces will be managed. Now we are finding out the DL1. DL1 is basically is equal to PL1 upon AB. DL1 for the section AB. P is the load. P is the load is given in the question is 50 kN. You have to convert that 50 kN into 50 Newton. So that's why we have to multiply by 1000 divided by area. Area is given is 1000 millimeter square. We put in the value of area, that is a 1000 millimeter. Multiply by Young modulus of elasticity, which is given. E is equal to 1.05 into 10 raised to 5 meter per mm square. Now we have to multiply by 600. Why we are considering the porosity? Because this is will be a tensile load. So that's why we are considering is a positive. Now we get the value of DL1 is equal to 0.2857 millimeter. You have seen the length of the this section is 600 mm. So all dimensions should be in mm. Now we are computing the DL2. DL2 is basically PL2 upon A. By putting the value of load, that is a 20 kN multiplied by 1000, that is a 20,000. Divided by 1000, that is the area, multiplied by Young modulus of elasticity, that is 1.05 into 10 raised to 5 multiplied by the length of the that section, and that section is given is 1 meter. It should be converted into millimeter. That's why we are multiplied by 1000, and that will be negative because this will be a compressive load. That will be in the form of negative. So we have to find out. We have to get the value of DL2 is 0.1904 millimeter. Same as we have to calculate the DL3. By putting the value of PL3 is P is given 10 kN multiplied by 1000, that is a 10,000, divided by area, and Young modulus of elasticity is equal to 1.05 to 10 raise of 5 is 1.2200, because the length of the structure is 1.2 meter. Now we get the total elongation. Total elongation is getting the summation of the all the section, that is the dl1 minus dl2 minus dl3. Why we are considering the negative? Because these two sections have compressive. So that's why we get the value of, by putting the value of dl1, dl2 and dl3, we get the final total elongation in the form of minus 0.1142 millimeter. Why it is millimeter? Because the elongation should be in the form of compressive. That's why it is come up into in the form of negative. Okay. Thank you, students.